Everybody was teasing me. Sylvia was wrong with that question, and I'm sure you heard it. I, instead of saying typhoon was the correct answer, I said tycoon was the correct. It is, of course, typhoon. I know it's from the book, The Greek Typhoon. It is, let's get back to the match here. Phil with a one-question lead over Paul, two questions over Sylvia. $15 money card going back on the board. Same game and the famous thing. I am an animal, of which there are about 40 million in the United States alone, making us responsible for a $1 billion industry. I am descended from a small animal that was also the ancestor of bears and raccoons. Paul.
A cow?
No.
A cattle?
Out of the rest of the question, we'll clear and continue for Sylvia and Phil. Took a chance, you say it funny. The early Egyptians considered me sacred. Sylvia.
Cat.
Cat is right, and Sylvia gets control of the board. $15 money card wears on
the end of this check.
Well, as we lock into your buzzer, you hit that 15, you would take over the lead, Sylvia. Good luck.
$15 money card, yes.
No, number two, and she gets
it's a car stereo. Voltron digital AM/FM car stereo cassette, mini equalizer amplifier, and three-way composite speakers. Furnished by Arthur Fulmer.
Very nice. We're over $400. You will enjoy it. And Phil going for $50,000 if he wins. She doesn't mind at all that they're not hitting money cards up there. Let's get back. It is still close. All three of you back in. Stanford's first graduating class included the man who was president. Phil?
Herbert Hoover.
When the Great Depression hit, you are right. Well, Bob, Hoover it is. Phil goes to 30. The bride of Frankenstein would be proud to wear this 45.5 carat gem complete with a curse called, Paul?
The Hope Diamond?
Well, Bob, that is exactly what it is. All the 25. Keeping the pressure on. In the famous Shakespeare play, who fulfilled the witch's prophecy by becoming the new king of Scotland? Paul?
Hamlet.
No. The other one. Macbeth.
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 Yeah.
Cost you five. Back down to 20.
Instant cash.
Bill, you have the lead with the instant cash. Now, if you were with us on the last show. Oh, here we go again. There are two of these boxes of $100 bills. One today. If you're with us on the last show, you'll still hit it for $11,000. So we start over again. $1,000. Now, Phil, it would cost you the amount of your lead. You have a $10 lead. Why am I doing this? I know he's going to forget that he's going for $50,000 and hit this buzzer right now. Going once, going twice, and he just missed it. Honestly, where was it? Which one would you have picked?
Three.
No, it's in number two.
Well,
Phil hangs on to the lead. What can I tell you? It is so very important. Good match. Back to it right after this. Jeff in Phil Cambray, he is in the lead. And if he is in the lead at the end of this game, he will play the winner's big money game for $50,000. But it remains close. Phil at 30, Paul at 20, Sylvia at 15. Here's a question for five. Traditionally, on what religious holiday would you see carolers singing? Sylvia.
Christmas.
Christmas it is. Sylvia back to 20. What European capital city was the setting for Edgar Allan Poe's chilling tale, Murders in the Rue Morgue? Phil.
Paris.
Paris is right, Jeff, in the 35. When 1997 rolls around, Great Britain will have to transfer, Paul?
Hong Kong?
That's right. Back to the Chinese. Hong Kong it is. Paul to 25. Close game. $15. Separate the players and all three money cards up there. So this is a big fame game and a famous thing. I am a colorless, odorless element that was discovered in the atmosphere in 1898. I was given the Greek word for new and became popular because of my eye-catching proprieties. When I replace the air in a glass tube and electricity is applied, I glow. Phil.
Neon.
Neon is right, and the champion gets control of the board. $25 money card wears.
Number eight.
Well, this is about the most important control you have had since you've been with us, Phil. Good luck.
Okay. $25 money card now.
He hits the $10 money card. That quite helped a lot. We have that $10 to Phil's score. Now, with the piano and a lot more on the line, we finish up this important match with the speed round. May I have 60 seconds on the clock? Looking at the score, Phil at 45, Paul at 25, Sylvia at 20. A lot of questions as we start the speed round now. George Hamilton played a modern-day Count Dracula. Paul.
Vampire Bat.
Time. What are you bringing to the Halloween party if you're buying dills and gherkins?
Phil.
Pickles.
Right. Some believe the ghost of Abraham Lincoln haunts the halls of what famous mansion in Washington?
Phil, White House.
Right. What kind of pet do you own if you're out promenading with your Pomeranian? Phil.
Horse.
Wrong. A vampire named Barnabas Collins haunted TV viewers, Phil.
Dark Shadow.
Yes. In the 1600s, what city in Massachusetts held a series of infamous... Paul.
Galen.
Right. What organ of the body sometimes has to be regulated by a pacemaker? Sylvia.
Heart.
Right. In what summer comedy flick did Michael Keaton play a charming Paul?
Beetlejuice.
Yes. To make someone fall in love, a witch would brew a special match. Still.
Love potion.
Yes. What famous pilot was attempting an around-the-world flight, Sylvia?
Amelia Earhart.
Right. Truman Capote's chilling book about a series of murders in Kansas is called... Paul?
In Cold Blood.
Right. In what western state can you visit the famous ghost town so time is up and still has the step for the champion. Back to him in just a moment. Just in quick and correct. The infamous witchcraft trials, I was going to say.